Hello, welcome to Statecraft IS and Social Perspectives Sociology in Newspaper series. In this series, we shall discuss daily news articles in sociological perspective and revise relevant sociology related UPSC mains concepts with the help of a newspaper on daily basis. In today's video, we have an article saying Assam employees to get an extra week's leave annually. Now CM announces geriatric care leave as Independence Day bonus. Now, if you go into the contents of the article, these Assam employees are now getting geriatric care leave of 1 week every year. This leave they must use to spend time with their parents and for no other purpose. Now, if we analyze this particular article in sociological perspective, we have Talcott Parsons talking about different systems. One is organismic system. This organismic system he has talked about in his earlier writings, but later when some of the sociologists criticized about this organismic system and heavily came upon his drawing parallels with society and biology, organisms, etc., later he withdrew this organismic system and retained only personality system, social system and cultural system. Now this particular move can bring social change is one of the arguments. If we just try to pose a question whether this particular move will bring social change or not, we just have to analyze this article in Talcott Parsons' perspective to arrive at an answer. Now whether this particular move bring any change to personality system? Yes. How? Now it gives particular motivation to the elderly in our families to live long. Motivation, that affection, personal love, bonding is developed at the personality level between the family members, between elderly and younger generations, because of the spending time of this younger generation with the elderly in the family. The CM's motive is to curb youth from sending their parents to old age homes. As he says, this sending parents to old age homes is never part of Indian ethos. Hence, in that particular aspect, this particular move will bring change to personality system, obviously. Now, whether it will bring change to social system? Yes. Definitely social linkages will develop, bondings between the different institutions will develop. Now elder generation or elderly people will have personal contact with younger ones, that means grandsons, granddaughters, etc. This will eventually imbibe some values of older generations to the newer people, and that will bring some change in the society in terms of its behavior. Hence that can bring in that particular aspect social system is bound to get impacted by this particular move. And how cultural system gets impacted? Because values like love, care for elderly, respect, all this can be ensured by the cultural system. Hence cultural system also gets impacted. Hence Parsons argues that there are personality system, social system and cultural system. Now he says personality system is the storehouse of energy and cultural system is the storehouse of information. Because it is this cultural system which has all the cultural information of cultural values, like values, morals, etc., are stored in this cultural system. Now these particular values like respect, love, care, etc., are transferred from cultural system to personality system. Because with this particular move, every person, every individual in the society will now feel that caring for elderly and respecting elders, showing love towards them, taking care of them, listening to their stories, sharing certain incidents with them. All these aspects now individuals believe or start to believe that they are integral to their lives, day-to-day lives. Hence, this information is transferred to personality system, and personality system is a storehouse of energy, and this particular energy to act, energy to live long, is transferred to the culture. Energy to bring some change in the society is transferred to the cultural system. Hence, in this manner, social change occurs, according to Talcott Parsons. Now, in this particular article also, if you see, in the Indian ethos, nothing is more disturbing and shameful than to see elderly parents in old age homes. So this is never, this has never been in the culture of India, and hence that cultural system which has been integral to the Indian ethos is trying to be brought back by this particular move. Hence, moving on to the next article, here it says, young athletes inspired by India's show at Olympics. Now, we have many times talked that Max Weber has something called power and authority concept. Power is nothing but ability to influence other people to do or not do some actions or inactions, even against their will. Authority is nothing but the authority which is driven by this power, and there are three kinds of authority according to Max Weber. One is charismatic authority, and the one is traditional authority, and the other one is rational legal authority. Now, this charismatic authority comes by the show of excellence. If any person gets excelled in some or the other field, then he inadvertently yields some authority, and that authority Max Weber calls as charismatic authority. Now, here also, these young athletes are inspired by the India show at Olympics. That means those who have succeeded in the recent Olympics, Tokyo Olympics, they are yielding nothing but charismatic authority, because they are able to influence these young athletes for some action. What is that action in this particular case? Training and getting into sports. This particular social action these young athletes are committing to, and that particular action is influenced by none other than those who have already succeeded or those who have performed well in the recent Olympics. Hence, we can say that those who have performed well in the recent Olympics are enjoying charismatic authority and influencing young athletes. Further, if we see here, it is there, as the threat of the third wave pandemic looms large over the country, young athletes are ready to take the challenges head on. Coaches and trainers have adopted technology, be it through Zoom training sessions or WhatsApp conversations, to train athletes so that their fight for international success will continue even if stadiums and facilities are shut. Now, Talcott Parsons has talked about agile functional prerequisites. In that agile functional prerequisites, A means adaptation. This adaptation, he said, is actually taken by economic system. That means this economic system gets adapted to the changes in the society and modifies its process of acquiring resources and distributing those resources among the members of the community. This Parsons has said as adaptation by the economic system. But here, if we see, this adaptation happens when there are changes to the economic system only. But here, change is not to the economic system, it is something external to all the systems, and that change is brought by COVID-19 and subsequent lockdowns. Hence, this change is not linked to economic system. That's why this adaptation is also not necessarily only by the economic system. This adaptation, if you see, it is happening in the social system, because COVID-19 induced lockdowns are affecting society through social distancing norms. Because of this social distancing norms only, people are not able to get trained in their regular stadiums, etc. Hence, this adaptation is affecting social system, unlike what Parsons has said that it will affect economic system. this adaptation here we have seen by Zoom training sessions or WhatsApp conversations. This society, the nature of conversation or nature of interaction by the society has changed through Zoom and WhatsApp sessions. And hence we can say that adaptation has been taken by social system in this particular example and not by economic system as Talcott Parsons has theorized. Hence that's all we have for today. If you like the content, please like, share and subscribe to Statecraft IS. If you have any comments or criticisms or if you have anything to say, please comment and let me know in the comment section. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day.